Sometimes late at night, I lie awake and watch her sleeping. She's lost in peaceful dreams, so I turn out the light, lay there in the dark. And the thought crosses my mind, if I never wake in the morning, would she ever doubt the way I feel about her in my heart? If tomorrow never comes, will she know how much I love? I try in every way to show her every day she's my only one. And if my time on earth were through, she must face this world without me. Is the love I gave her in the past gonna be enough to last? Tomorrow never comes, 'cause I've lost loved ones in my life who never knew how much.
Hello, readers in Albania. This is Jill Santopolo, and I just wanted to say hello and thank you all for your support of my first book, and I hope that you enjoy the second one too.
So I made a promise to myself, say each day how much he means to me, and avoid that circumstance where there's no second chance to tell her how I feel. If tomorrow never comes, does she know how much I love her? Did I try in every way to show her every day she's my only one? And if my time on earth went through, she must face this world without me. Gonna be enough to last if tomorrow never comes. So tell that someone that you love just what you're thinking of if tomorrow never comes.
A friend of mine at Penguin Young Readers read an early copy of the book and told me how much it made her think about her father, who passed away about 15 years ago. And her email made me so happy, because that's what I hope this book will do. Touch people in a way that makes them think of their own stories, of their own lives, and delve into their own emotions.
No matter what they tell us, no matter what they do, no matter what they teach us, what we believe is true. No matter what they call us, however they attack, no matter where they take us, we'll find our own way back.
More Than Words, a beautiful novel about family secrets and romance and really finding out about who you are and who you want to be.
I know our love forever. I know no matter what, if only tears were laughter.
After my dad died, who were left to that awful task of dealing with the physical items he left behind. I found a letter my mother had written my father after they'd had some sort of argument in the early 1990s. I don't know what it was about, because after I read the first two lines of the note, I folded it back up and stuck it in its envelope. Maybe it's a deplorable lack of curiosity in a writer that I didn't want to read it, but I didn't. And I brought the letter to my mother for her to do whatever she wanted with. And that was the moment that More Than Words became a more filled-in sketch in my mind. The what if. The what if I'd learned something about my father, about my parents, that I didn't want to know. So in More Than Words, Nina does.
No matter where it's barren, my dream is being born.
I don't want to ruin anything, but she discovers things. Let's just say it that way.
Yeah.
And not knowing, changing, you know, you grow up with a certain image of your parents. And like you said, you know, you didn't find that letter, but what if I had this letter? And, you know, I think you keep that image, and it's such a loving image, and it's something you will cherish and hold on forever. And I can't imagine going through this and realizing, but I think, I don't want to give too much away, but when you realize that you still love this person, and that you realize that everyone is human,
right?
And we make our mistakes.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And I think that's one of the best things about this. And I think what I love this about that, you know, here's a young woman who has grown up with such privilege, and maybe she doesn't understand the way other people have grown up, but she's willing to change. Mm-hmm. And I think maybe finding things out that people aren't perfect, she can realize it's sort of a freedom for her.
Yeah.
And I think that I just love to see her morphing into figuring out exactly who she is and who she wants to be. And I think that was one of the best parts of the book for me.
Thank you. Yeah.
I know this love's forever. That's all that matters now, no matter. It's amazing how you can speak right to my heart. Without saying a word, you can light up the dark. Try as I may, I can never explain what I hear when you don't say a thing. The smile on your face lets me know that you need me. There's a truth in your eyes saying you'll never leave me. The touch of your hand says you'll catch me wherever I fall. Say it best when you say nothing at all.
I was also falling in love as I wrote this book with the man I'm going to marry in June. And that was something else that filled in the sketch. I was volunteering on Hillary Clinton's 2016 campaign, so politics was part of it, and why people choose to work in that world added another layer of detail to my story. They were all emotions that I wanted to record, wanted to write down in my own way.
You drown out the crowd. Try as they may, they can never define what's been said between your heart and mine. The smile on your face lets me know. Says you'll catch me wherever I fall.
You've done so much in the book industry, but knowing that this is your second adult novel, with your first being a huge New York Times bestseller, now being translated into 35 languages, was it hard to sit down and write your second, having had that incredible success? Did you feel it was a bit of a daunting process?
It was a little bit. It was because the craziest thing, at least for me, from The Light We Lost, which was something that I never thought would happen, is that I get readers who email me and they direct message me through Instagram and Twitter and Facebook and all these things, and they send me these messages that say, you know, I read your book and I really liked it because I experienced this too. And then at the end it says something like, looking forward to reading what you come up with next. And I thought, the whole time I was writing, I was like, I can't disappoint them. I can't disappoint all these people who took the time to read my book and took the time to reach out to me and tell me how they felt. And now I'm writing something else, and oh my gosh, what if they don't like it?